This is the Italian Citizenship Podcast, hosted by Marco Permunian and Rafael Di Furia. Hello and welcome to another edition of the Italian Citizenship Podcast, presented by ItalianCitizenshipAssistance.com. I am here with Italian attorney Marco Permunian, and I am Rafael Di Furia. And today we wanted to talk a little bit about the AIRE. What is it? What's it for? What's the big deal? So let's just get straight into it. And Marco, what is the AIRE? What is this thing that nobody quite understands?
The AIRE is the Registry of Italian Citizens Residing Abroad. It was launched in 1988, and it's a registry that indicates where you live outside of Italy. And you are required to register with the AIRE only if you are planning on residing outside of Italy for more than 12 months. All Italian citizens residing abroad should be registered with the AIRE, regardless of the fact that they became Italian citizens by descent, so they were recognized as Italian citizens through an Italian consulate, or that they are Italian citizens born in Italy and that just relocated from Italy to another country, such as the US.
And how is it that someone goes about registering for the AIRE? What's necessary to do?
If you are a person who emigrated from Italy to a foreign country, you have to look for the instructions that are published on the website of the Italian consulate, your local Italian consulate. There will likely be some forms that you have to fill out and mail to the consulate or email to the consulate. Or I know some consulates right now have in place a system where you register online and you just submit electronically your AIRE application, and then you have to allow a few weeks, sometimes a couple of months, for the consulate to register you. And what the consulate does is the consulate communicates with the Italian municipality where you were originally registered to inform them that you are no longer a resident of their town because you moved abroad. And if you are recognized through jure sanguinis, so if you became an Italian citizen through the consulate will register you most likely automatically, so without the need for you to do anything.
And is there a benefit to being registered with the AIRE, or how does this affect a person's life, practically speaking?
So being registered with the AIRE allows you to access the consular services. So only if you are registered with the AIRE, you can use the services offered by the consulate, such as applying for a passport or renewing your Italian passport or registering a major life event like your marriage or your divorce or the birth of any children. So you can do all that only if you are registered with the AIRE. If you're not, you first have to register, and then you can do that.
And so being registered with the consulate in the AIRE, since it allows you to use the consular services, would this also mean that in the case of what happened in China, for example, with the coronavirus outbreak, that a person would be able to be evacuated? Is that related in some way?
I believe that the fact that you're registered with the AIRE allows the Italian government to know how many of its citizens are residing abroad. So if you're not registered with the AIRE because you're staying in the foreign country for less than 12 months, or because you never registered because you didn't know you had to, the Italian government won't know that you are an Italian citizen residing in a foreign country. And if they don't know, they may not be able to help you when you need their help.
So even though it may be a little annoying if you have to register yourself with the Italian consulate, in the case of an emergency, it may actually be
very helpful.
Yeah. Are there any other benefits aside from being able to access consular services and so on if you're registered in the AIRE?
For example, if you want to apply for a new passport or just renew your old passport, you can do it only if you are registered with the AIRE. So if you're not registered, you would have to register first, and then you would be able to use the consulate to get a new passport, unless it's an emergency. So you're traveling in the foreign country just for a couple of weeks and you happen to lose your passport, in that case, they will help you anyway. But if you are a long-term resident of the foreign country and you have to renew your passport, you will have to register with the AIRE if you haven't done that already. And the other benefit of being registered with the AIRE is that you are allowed to vote through the consulate, so with no need for you to go back to Italy to vote for the national elections. You can do it through the consulate. So the consulate will mail to you the voting documents that you can just return by mail to the consulate.
And aside from the benefits, are there any duties or responsibilities that an Italian citizen has while they're living abroad?
Sure. First of all, you have to make sure that you keep your AIRE file up to date. So your address should always be your current address. So if you move from one location to another, you should inform the local consulate that you have changed address. Or if you changed consular jurisdiction, you should inform the new consulate that you are now a resident of their jurisdiction. What the consulate does is then they inform your Italian municipality that your address has changed, because the AIRE registry is a registry that is held jointly by the consulate and an Italian municipality, which is the municipality where you were residing when you were back in Italy, or if you became an Italian citizen by descent, they normally use the municipality of birth of your Italian ancestor. So for the municipality, for example, to send the documents for you to vote, they send them through the consulate, but if the consulate doesn't have your current address on file, they will not be able to send you those documents in the mail. And the thing is, if the consulate sends you the documents to vote through the mail and those documents bounce back to the consulate because you're no longer living at that address, that could be a problem, and that could result into the consulate having to remove you from their system.
And so if they remove you from their system, that means you're no longer registered with them. Does that mean you're just kind of technically floating around in legal no man's land?
Exactly. So it's important that you keep your address always updated. And if you get canceled, you have to register again. It's not a big deal, but you have to go through the registration process again.
And you mentioned that with the registration process that you can do it by mail or online. Is there ever a case where they may require you to come in person, or it can always be done long distance?
Generally, they don't require you to appear in person at the consulate. So it's either by mail, email, or through their new online system that is now in place.
Are there any other responsibilities that an Italian citizen would have when they're living abroad?
Yes. So if you are an Italian citizen registered with the AIRE, you have to register all of your personal vital record documents related to major life events. For example, if you get married in the US, if you're living in the US, you should register your marriage certificate with the apostille and the translation into Italian through the consulate. So the consulate will take care of registering the record in Italy in the municipality where you are registered with the AIRE. Same goes for a divorce. So if you get divorced in the US, you have to get the final judgment of divorce and register that through the consulate. Or same goes for the death of a family member. So if you have a parent living with you or a grandparent who passes away, and if that person is an Italian citizen registered with the AIRE, you should register the death certificate of that person through the consulate. And the same applies to the birth of children. So if you have children while living abroad, and if you are an Italian citizen registered with the AIRE, you should register their birth certificates in Italy through the consulate. And by the way, that's when your children become Italian citizens.
And just to clarify one thing, when you were saying about that you have to register all vital events and documents, these would, if you're somebody who's getting Italian citizenship by descent, or you already got your Italian citizenship by descent, this doesn't mean that you have to register the documents that you already gave to the consulate. It's
correct.
Only the documents after you've gained your citizenship and after you've gained your recognition from that point forward.
Yes.
One thing that is very important to people who are getting their Italian citizenship by descent is to be able to get their Italian passport, some form of Italian identification. How would a person go about that process? You mentioned before that if a person wants to get their Italian passport, it's necessary to be registered in the IRE. But how would they actually go about getting the passport?
So the prerequisite, as you just said, is being registered with the IRE. If you are, you can just book an appointment at your local Italian consulate to apply for a passport. Normally, the consulate will have a booking system, an online booking system. So you just create your account on the website of the consulate and just you select an available date and you show up at your appointment with all the documents and forms needed to apply for a passport, which, by the way, you can find on the website of the consulate. And after your appointment, the consulate will just mail you back the passport at your residency address, or sometimes they will just give it to you on the spot.
So from what you're saying, it sounds as though this application appointment is in person. You can't do this just by mail.
Correct, because they have to take your fingerprints, and that applies also to minor children if they are over 12. So children who are over 12 can apply for a passport, or actually you can apply for a passport on their behalf, but they have to appear in person at the consulate, whereas children who are under 12 do not need to be fingerprinted, so there is no need for them to travel to the consulate, and you can actually mail in the application form for their passport application through the mail.
But what about for renewing a passport rather than getting a passport for the first time?
It would be the same process.
And among those people who are interested in Italian citizenship and getting their Italian passport, there is that subset of us, me being one of them personally, who have an interest of actually living in Italy. Is it necessary to have the Italian passport to come to move to Italy, or can you just arrive here?
The thing is, if you don't have an Italian passport and if you are an Italian citizen, so if you enter the country as an American citizen, you can only stay for 3 months and then you have to leave. Whereas if you are an Italian citizen with an Italian passport, you can just enter as an Italian citizen and just stay for as long as you like.
But what about somebody who wants to move to Italy, but they don't quite have the time because they're under a time crunch for whatever reason, maybe a job or something, and they're unable to get their Italian passport before moving here? Is that something that they can do?
So you mean someone who was recognized as an Italian citizen by the consulate in the US and then wants to relocate to Italy before getting an Italian passport?
Yeah.
I believe in that situation, it would be wise to just get an Italian passport through the consulate before moving to Italy, because if you move to Italy and enter the country as an American citizen, so with your original passport, you would not be able to register with the Anagrafe, so register as a resident of Italy based on your foreign passport. So you wouldn't be able to then get an Italian passport from within Italy.
And what about the situation for somebody who does want to move to Italy and they have their Italian passport and they come here? What happens to their IRE file?
So when you go to Italy as an Italian citizen, if you're planning on staying in Italy long term, you should register as a resident of an Italian municipality. And what happens is when you do register, your Italian municipality will communicate to the consulate that you are no longer residing within the consular jurisdiction. So you become a citizen of Italy who was living abroad and is now living in Italy. So you get canceled from the IRE and you get registered with the population of an Italian town.
And so this sounds a lot like the system that's in place when a person who is an Italian citizen in Italy moves from one municipality to the other, where they just transfer the file from one place to the other.
Yes, correct.
But what about the situation for somebody who lives abroad, maybe an Italian who moved to the U.S. or even somebody who is recognized by Iure Sanguinis and has been living in that country for a long time, whether it's on a green card or whatever it is, that they remain an Italian citizen and that they're registered with the IRE, but they don't ever do anything with their passport and they just let it expire, or they lose their passport, whatever it might be, what would happen to them?
So I've been contacted by a lot of people who are in a similar situation. So people who were born in Italy and are Italian citizens because they either never became U.S. citizens or because they became U.S. citizens after 1992. So they kept their Italian citizenship. So these people frequently are people who have been living abroad for a long time, 20, 30 years, 40 years, sometimes even before the EIDAS system was in place. So I'm often contacted by these people who ask me, what do I have to do to get my Italian passport, because maybe they never renew it, or because it was expired, or because they've been living and traveling with a US passport because they became US citizens. And the answer is that you first have to register with the AIRE, but to do so, you also have to register all of your personal vital record documents. So if after you emigrated, you got married one time or multiple times, you got divorced, you had children, you have to register all of your vital record documents through the consulate. And then once you have done that, you can apply for a passport, so you can get an Italian passport.
And when a person registers themselves in the AIRE system, is it with the embassy or a consulate?
So you have to register with your local Italian consulate, not the embassy, but rather your local consulate. There are few consulates of Italy in the US, actually more than a few. They are located in some major cities. So we have, like, starting from the East Coast, we have the Italian consulate in Boston, New York, Philadelphia, Miami, Houston, Detroit, Chicago, Los Angeles, San Francisco, and I hope I'm not forgetting any consulates.
That sounds pretty good to me. I'm impressed that you had all that memorized.
And you have to register with one of those consulates that have jurisdiction over a portion of the United States.
So for example, like if you're living in Arizona, you would fall under Los Angeles jurisdiction.
Correct.
But if you're living in Seattle, you would fall under the San Francisco jurisdiction.
Yes.
So you need to make sure that you're registered with the consulate that is, they have the say, so to speak, over your area.
Exactly.
But what about an honorary consulate? Would you be able to register through one of those?
No, honorary consulates do not keep an AIRE registry. So the AIRE registry is only kept by a consulate general of Italy.
So we've spoken about what the AIRE is, how to register, what are the benefits, what are the responsibilities, but what are the documents required when you need to change your residence within the same consular jurisdiction, or even changing from one consular jurisdiction to another?
So generally, the consulate requires your identification, so a passport or an ID, and proof of residency. Specifically, they generally require utility bills or bank statements or letters from some official, like public offices. So basically documents that prove 100% where you reside, so that's your residency address.
And why is that so important for them to have this specific address and not just simply to be registered as part of their consulate?
Yeah, that's because the Italian government keeps tracks of where its citizens reside for a variety of reasons. So if they have to send you official documents in the mail, or just to know how many people reside abroad and in what countries these people are located. So that's basically why it's so important that your address is up to date.
That actually is quite interesting, and it makes sense, because I know in some situations, depending on the province you reside in or the region you reside in, that will potentially affect your taxation situation, potentially tax benefits, tax breaks, whatever it may be, or it may affect your healthcare coverage, because the healthcare is covered by the region or sometimes the province, depending on where you are. They will have their own registry of how they take care of that. But that's more for if you're actually living in Italy and you can't necessarily benefit from those things if you're residing outside of Italy. However, as you've mentioned in a previous episode, that an Italian who resides abroad will not have the same tax liability or really any tax responsibilities like how an American citizen might have if they're living abroad. But anyway, I think this might be a good place to wrap up for this time. So thank you all so much for joining us for another edition of the Italian Citizenship Podcast presented by ItalianCitizenshipAssistance.com. And if you would like to see more of this video podcast, please be sure to subscribe. And if you have any questions about anything that we've spoken about in this episode or any other episode of the Italian Citizenship Podcast, be sure to leave that down in the comment section below, and we may be able to get to that in a future video. Of course, this is Italian attorney Marco Permunian, and I am Raffaele Di Furia. We look forward to seeing you all next time. See ya.
Thank you. Bye.